Extraction methods. Maceration. In these methods, the biomass material is soaked in a suitable solvent for a specific period with a frequent agitation. The process results in the solubilization of cell wall and release the soluble components into the solvent. The components are later obtained from the solvent. The method is very simple. However, it requires a long extraction time, require up to 3 days, and the extraction efficiency is also lower. Percolation. Percolation involves the extraction of the biomass components by pressing the solvents through column containing biomass material. Coffee is a classic example for percolation method of extraction. When hot water is added to the coffee powder, the soluble components along with the water are filtered out, leaving the insoluble components in the coffee filter. The process involves the constant replacement of saturated solvent by fresh solvent, and thus it is more efficient than the maceration process. Decoction. Decoction method is used to extract biomass components by heating the biomass along with the solvent. Biomass materials such as stem, bark, root, etc. are prepared for this method. This method is not suitable for heat sensitive as well as volatile components. The reflux extraction. The reflux extraction method consists of a vessel and a water cooled condenser at the top of it. The biomass material and the solvent is taken in the vessel, is boiled to produce vapor that contain the biomass components. The vapor are cooled by the condenser and returned to the vessel. As the process does not require much time, and as it needs only a lesser amount of solvent and is more efficient than maceration and percolation. However, the process is not suitable for the extraction of heat-sensitive substances. Succinate extraction. The method is an integration of both percolation and reflection, invented by Franz von Succinate in 1879. Distillation flask, extraction chamber, thimble, siphon, bypass the side arm, and condenser are the major part of the succinate extraction system. The biomass material is taken in a thimble, placed in the extraction chamber, and the solvent is taken in the distillation flask. When the distillation flask is heated, the solvent gets vaporized and moved towards the condenser through bypass side arm. The condensed solvent falls into the thimble containing biomass. The warm solvent results in the release of soluble biomass components into the solvent. When the thimble gets filled with solvent, the excess solvent along with the biomass components return to the distillation flask through siphon. Supercritical fluid extraction. This process requires supercritical fluids for extracting the biomass components. Supercritical fluids are any substance at a certain temperature and pressure known as critical point is indistinguishable whether it is a liquid state or a gaseous state. A substance above its critical point is known as supercritical fluids. Supercritical fluids has the ability to solubilize a wide range of products as it has solubility similar to liquid and diffusivity similar to gas. Supercritical carbon dioxide is widely used as extraction solvent since it has a low critical temperature, 31 degree centigrade, selectivity, inertness, low cost, non-toxicity, and it can extract thermolabile substances. Pressurized liquid extraction. The method uses high temperature and pressure in order to extract biomass components with suitable solvent. High pressure has the advantage of keeping the solvent in liquid state at a high temperature. The condition of the method enhances the solvent property such as high diffusion coefficient, low viscosity, and high solvent strength, which favors the extraction process. The high pressure also forces the solvent to penetrate the biomass, which makes the extraction process faster. Ultrasound assisted extraction. The process is also known as ultrasonic extraction or sonication. The method uses ultrasonic waves with a frequency higher than 20 kHz for the extraction of biomass components. Microwave assisted extraction. This method uses microwaves for the extraction of biomass components. When interacting with the polar components, for example water, of the biomass material, microwave radiation produces heat. This results in the loss of all the moisture component in the biomass, which generates a pressure on cell wall from inside, and ultimately the cell wall is ruptured. This makes the extraction process easier. Enzyme assisted extraction. Uses of high temperature for the extraction of biomass components results in the degradation of heat sensitive substances. Enzyme assisted extraction method can be used to efficiently extract such substances. Enzymes like cellulose, pectinase, etc. can hydrolyze the cell wall components and thus enhance the release of desired components. Hydro distillation and steam distillation. These methods are commonly used for the extraction of volatile oil. In hydro distillation, the biomass material is soaked in water and boiled in a distillation chamber. The oil mixed with water is later can be separated by difference in their vapor pressure through condensation. In steam distillation, the biomass material placed in the distillation chamber interact with the steam. The essential oil in the biomass vaporize in the presence of steam, and later it is condensed back to liquid oil.